With
Marie.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sonia, and this is Colleen.
Hello.
And you may recognize us from our series, Microsoft Unboxed.
And we're very excited to be here today with some incredibly smart 11th graders to give you a special episode of What's New in EDU.
This month, we're dedicating the whole episode to celebrating women and girls who are using their passion for STEM and computer science to solve big problems and create amazing things.
So what are your projects on?
Well, I'm building an app to help like the mental state of refugees.
Oh my goodness. Wow. That's amazing. What's your project on?
And we're trying to filter water without energy inputs.
Well, we're just looking at like a sort of like biomimicry solution that we can use in like small scale applications for areas that don't have access to clean water.
Oh, amazing.
With help of these students, we're going to kick things off by examining what the numbers tell us about gender equality. Then we'll move into how we can close the gap.
We're turning to Flipgrid to share our voices. So for all of you out there, make sure to take a look at our grid. Everyone, you ready to get started here?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Esther, are you ready to kick us off?
Yeah.
Okay.
According to a 2018 study called Closing the STEM Gap, 31% of girls believe that jobs requiring coding and programming are not for them.
In high school, that number jumps up to 40%.
By college, 58% of girls count themselves out of these jobs.
So it's no surprise that when asked to describe a typical scientist, engineer, mathematician, computer programmer, 30% of girls say that they envision a man in these roles.
Studies show that girls who know a woman in STEM are more likely to engage in STEM than those who don't.
These are statistics worth paying attention to. So please make sure to check out and share these videos on Flipgrid. And thank you ladies for staying behind after school. I really appreciate it. I bet you guys have plenty of homework to get back to in your project, so thank you for joining us today. Now, that's not all. You may be asking, how do we reverse these trends? Of course, one of the most important first steps is introducing girls and young women to positive female role models in STEM fields. And we're always curating resources. Let's take a look. We have wonderful educator community members like Amy Rosenstein and Tammy Dunbar teaching Skype courses on gender equality. You can also find courses on gender equality and UN sustainability goals, empowering girls to pursue STEM, and how to use Microsoft Education Community resources to encourage STEM skills. And don't forget to register your classrooms for a free Skype in the Classroom broadcast and live chat with Dr. Jane Goodall on April 2nd and 9th. Your students will learn how small actions can make a big impact on our planet and get inspired. Make sure to mark your calendars for that one.
In the meantime, check out the free STEM action guide at aka.ms/girls-in-stem to get started encouraging STEM in your classroom.
And if you're on Twitter, join our Tweet Meet every third Tuesday of the month. This month, educators will be sharing how they empower their students to hashtag make what's next with inspiration, ideas, and new STEM resources from educators all over the world.
All right, Sonia, I think that's gonna wrap things up for this month's special episode.
For more info and resources, go check out the blog. And make sure to check out our grid on Flipgrid too.
See you next time.